Okay, well, hey folks, I always have a problem with that webcam. I don't know what it is, but anyway, hey, great to see you today, and thanks so much for coming to our presentation on Catch a Wave. It's a fast-moving train. There's stuff happening every day with this, so we know we've got some owners with us and also people interested in Catch a Wave, so just really glad all of you are here today for this presentation by Jeff Drake and myself at Doubts. Let me make sure you can hear me before I start launching into this, because you know how it goes. Okay. So Eric says loud and clear in Fort Lauderdale. Russell says, yay. All right. Benjamin, Thomas, Chris. Oh, great. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much. Okay. Well, nice day here in Austin. You can see my window there. It's got the blue sky behind me. So it's all good. All right. So we're going to, this is going to be kind of a two-part presentation. We do want to show people what Catch a Wave is. So the early material is going to be kind of, you know, introductory, like what it is, why we did it, you know, how it's working out. And then we've got some special things to share with you that are sort of breaking news kinds of items about this plugin, or really it's not a plugin, it's a whole system, because it has MarketScans, VisualTrader, the strategies and the training and everything. So there's a lot to it. So I want to make sure everybody understands what it is if you're considering catching a wave with us. So let's go ahead and start here. And just look at kind of what you see with this. And it is, you may recognize the look of that screen. It is based on WaveTrader to a large extent. Those are the WaveTrader fractal colors. And basically, we know that WaveTrader does a really good job of finding trending moves by virtue of Elliott wave pivots that it identifies. And so the Catch a Wave product is really kind of based on that. And that's where the wave comes from. It's WaveTrader. But there's a lot more to it. That's kind of the genesis of it. So let's look at kind of what happened with this and how it came into being and the elements of it. This was something that a Nirvana Club member by the name of Larry Smith came to me with back in February. And he just wrote in saying he was using these tools and said, man, you know, Ed, the combination of these things is really powerful. Like he was making money almost every day, and he showed me, you know, what he was doing with it. I was amazed, frankly. And so what happened was my director of development, Constantine, got on board with this, and you know, because we were considering building a package for this product to trade in real time, if it really was that good. And so he starts trading with it, and lo and behold, he says, Ed, this is really good stuff. So we went on to decide to do it, but What's so great about it is that Larry discovered that the combination of WaveTrader with the VWAP indicator and a moving average on certain symbols at certain times and with certain, you know, scans bringing them in are really, really powerful moves. He was mainly shorting things real pretty close to the open. You know, we have all of these, the meme stocks being bid up. That's one case. But even aside from them, there's just lots and lots of stocks that get bid up in the pre-market or even the day before, and then they fail when the regular session opens, and this also can happen during the pre-market. And so that's just a really good opportunity. Tremendous moves happen very, very quickly. As we built the product and added the assets into VisualTrader and MarketScans to really work this, we found that there's a lot of great opportunities just all during the session. And so we're gonna be talking about that as we go through it. Let's go ahead and look very quickly at the elements of this, because it is kind of WaveTrader, VWAP are the two of the first ones. So let's talk about those first. VWAP is volume weighted average price. It's used by a lot of day traders, institutions. It's you know, it's a volume weighted average price from the prior session. And if you have pre-market turned on, it includes that as well. So it is very good at showing you whether you're above the mean or below the mean, which means, you know, in an upward trending mode or downward trending. So that's an indicator that we've had around for a while. And it is, like I said, fairly common out there among day traders. The second, of course, is this WaveTrader fractal color chart, which again, the WaveTrader pivots, which is what this is based on, are Elliott wave derived. And they're really good at finding changes in direction during the session based on WaveTrader measurements. So those are kind of the two primary parts of it. Oh, I just got an alert came in. I don't know if y'all can hear those as they come in on VisualTrader, but we're gonna get there in a second. Anyway, so when you combine those three things together with a moving average to help you determine a trigger point, the moves are really spectacular. Here's just two that happened at the same time. And this is when I was actually trading with it one day. So I captured these two shots. I was in a short on the one below, but this is just what happens with this. You often see these things take off and just move a lot after those conditions occur. Okay, so I have some examples here. What basically happened with this is after Larry brought it to us, we started a very vigorous Skype conversation and just were kind of passing trades in. Some of these, you know, Larry captured, we've got a couple that we captured, but I just want to show you, you know, some of them. I mean, there's probably, I don't know, 100 charts in that thread, but I just pulled some out to sort of show what this looks like. So you've got the VWAP indicator, moving average, going through VWAP, and then that move is a very nice, like about almost 10% move right there. It doesn't look like much, but then you also have the above moves like this, but then you have this one here. So near the open and boom, takes off, you know, moves a huge amount, huge percentage move. Here's another one here, right after the open, down, and then of course the red wave, and you know, VWAP's right there, you're below VWAP going down. Here, this one was taken by Constantine, the developer, he's actually our director of development that I told you about. He was writing this himself, and you know, because we were trying to decide if we wanted to actually work a product around this. And he's like a $2,000 gain on PHUN that he pointed out was one that he got into short right there as we were developing the project. So, you know, this is a great indicator combination. I mean, really, you could just come to this webinar and kind of use those things and they work really well. The thing though, if you're gonna make money with this day trading, you need a little more firepower than just the indicator, because there's, as you know, thousands of stocks out there. And so you gotta know which ones it's happening to. And so to do that, you've gotta have a scanner. And then to trade with it, there's some other tools that really, really help. So the development work really went into the platform, which is a combination of two things. We're gonna go and look at that right now, the CatchWave trading platform. The first is MarketScans. And it's been around for a while. Constantine built this a number of years ago. And there's a group of users who have been using it, you know, continuously, and they've loved it. It's fantastic. But what Constantine did to it for this release is phenomenal. That's why we call it MarketScans too, because it's like a whole new animal. You know, there's some basic things he did, like color coding the entries in the list. So you can, that's based on percent change, so you can see which ones are up a lot, which ones are down a lot, and some other things I'll show you in a second when I bring it up. But the main thing that happened with MarketScans was speed, because for all of the scans that we provide that we've written on our server, we can run those. We can support thousands of users on a scan because it is a scan that is running, and we distribute the scan results out to all the people subscribed to it. So using one of our scans, it is literally instantaneous. We're talking about sub-second monitoring of the market. So when something happens in one of these conditions, and of course the conditions are over here on the right, if something happens, it comes in. So they're constantly being added, as opposed to waiting until the end of the bar. So if you're looking at 1 minute data, for example, a 1 minute scan, it would wait until the end of that minute, and then it would run the analysis, which is okay, but not nearly as good as every second, because seconds count in this game. Let me tell you, the market moves so fast at times that you've got to have the candidates coming into you really, really quickly. So that was a huge, huge upgrade. And I tell the guys, I think we should charge a lot of money for MarketScans because it is so dang fast. Okay, so the other thing, of course, is VisualTrader 12.5. And people have, you know, asked, well, why VisualTrader, not OmniTrader? OmniTrader is a great platform. Those of us who have been day trading in here kind of like doing it in VisualTrader more for a couple of reasons that I'm going to get into when we get to the software. But aside from just that we think it's just a better animal for doing this, there's some features that were added to VisualTrader 12 to make it 12.5, including the addition of a scan in column so you can see, you know, when the symbols are coming in the list. And the really big one is the way the alerts work, which I'm going to show you when I bring up the software. So let me go ahead and do that. Oh, yeah. Let me go do that right now. I go here and click on VT. All right, and market scan. All right, so maybe do a little trading here. You never know. We'll see. I'm coming in here without any trades, so I won't be distracted by that while I'm talking to y'all. So here is market scans. You can see this stuff is dynamically changing in here. If I move some things around on my desktop, okay. So if I open it up, you can see that, you know, I've got a catch a wave scan. I'm monitoring liquid and intraday movers. And of course, the definition of the scan is over here. Some other changes were made to market scans that I haven't talked about yet. Speed's the big deal, really the huge deal about it. And you'll see these symbols coming in on this as we run here. But that's why we did this at 2 o'clock, so you could see this stuff working. But Constantine added a specific indicator to look for how many bars are present in the last so many periods, because you'll see stocks come in that are just really thin, like they don't trade for maybe 10 minutes or 15 minutes at a time. So we want to avoid those. So he created that. So that's a very nice thing for liquidity. And of course, we worked on these scans and all that as part of the catch-away package. So scans and strategies are kind of a separate thing. Those are added into this. And we're done for catch-away. But the other thing he did is he added this deal where you can tell it to tell you which, if I enable this audio alerts here, when a symbol comes into a scan list, it'll actually speak it. It's a male or a female voice, and it'll tell you which scan it came from. So you can not be looking at it, and it'll tell you exactly what just came in the list. That's very, very helpful. So again, that's market scans. And typically, you just kind of minimize it because it's doing its job back there. In VisualTrader, then, we have, as you know, these groups. And this is another reason VisualTrader is good, because it is already based on a group hierarchy. So here's my catch a wave liquid scans right here. And all I do is go in and add them. I just say right click, add market scan group, and add it right there. And it comes in. And of course, VisualTrader has the cylinder representation of stuff, which is, I'll get into why that's so great for this product in a minute here, but that's just kind of how this works out here. But the same thing is in the list. The big green cylinders are the big green cylinders here on their sides and all that stuff. So these are groups over here, and they're continually coming in. Well, they get added in VisualTrader, and then we see the next big thing. You'll go to the queue here. The next big thing that happens is, on the right, as they are generated, they flash in the list. You see them coming in right now. BBIG just came in just now. That signal right there, okay, right there, just happened on this. All right, and we're above VWAP. Okay, we're gonna hold off on trading for a second here, but there you go. It's a pretty opportunity. And so they come in, but the other thing that Kosei added, I don't think you can hear this and go to webinar because I don't think it's connected exactly, but is that it will speak the symbol as it comes in. This is something new that he added. It's this little thing right down here, text to voice symbol plus whatever. And if you're using a, you can say, you know, say this name, catch a wave. So I can actually say this plus catch a wave, type that in there, and it will say LABD. Catch a wave. So I know which scan that came from without even looking at it. Okay. So this is, you can see I've got these two alerts in here for both catch a wave and intraday movers, both scans, and they're coming in on the right. So again, they come in here, they flash. And so what's so great about this is you can do other things. You know, I can have VT up all day long and just wait for a signal to come in. Or the symbol to come in from the scanner, and then for a signal to be generated, and it shows up over there. And I just click it, and here's LAB, see the LABU, yep. And so it's got a new short signal right here, just fired. All right, and let's see, this is hard to do live, but I'm gonna do it anyway. So here's a long signal on Vino. Must be a wine company, I don't know. So Vino, all right, so we're gonna go long Vino. Here's where I can show you the other big deal that was added to VT. And it's called hot buttons down here. So, you know, we go and click that little box to launch the trade plan for that strategy that just fired. And all I got to do is say, okay, give me, you know, whatever, 10% equity, whatever it is, 25% of my position. I can just get in right there and it's it. And there's my stop loss, my, you know, break even, all that are just right there in the chart. And I'm off to the races. I can move on to my next one. Okay, so let's see. Now I've got VIXY. All right, that is a short signal. It's kind of gone down a lot already. That's a good move, but I think I'll hold off on that one. Let's see, UVXY. We all know what that does. Okay, that's down there now. Yeah, same. It must be a derivative, same symbol. VXX, already looked at. All right, LABU, we did not trade yet. So let's say this one, I go, okay, I'm above VWAP in the green, going up. So I decide I like that candidate. Again, I can hit the little chevron here and I can buy, I can just use these settings up here, or I can use a button. So let me go ahead and do this one. Let's go ahead and enter right there. All right. And okay, so I'm in that trade. Now, let's just say I'm trading this and I want to scale into the trade or scale out. That's where the hot buttons come into play. And I can see how they're defined just by going to edit mode down here. Okay. And by clicking any button, I can see exactly what it's set as. This is 10% E, 10% of equity, a market order, time and force day. That's how that button is defined. Or I can say, you know, sell. So sell 10% of equity. Now here's how you use this, and I'm just gonna throw caution to the wind here, folks. So again, to show you what this does, I'm making money though, that's good. All right, so exit edit mode, and I'm gonna say keep this on top, keep this on the desktop. So I can have this around, and you see up here I've got, okay, it says there's one share, which I didn't set quantity when I did this a few minutes ago, but I say no, I don't want just one share, I want to get some more. So 10% of equity, and boom, there's 143 shares now. And let's do it again. Boom. Now there's 265 shares. So it's just putting those orders in as I click that. I can scale out the same way. I can sell 25% of my position by clicking that, or I can set a bid or ask requirement. And that's really cool how that works. Let me show you. So I'm going to edit mode again. If I click here, you'll see it says bid. But I can also say bid minus 0.01 to give it a little bit of slack so I don't get shut out of the trade if it's just 1 cent off. So I can literally type that in right there and change it, then go out of edit mode and I'm back to here. So, you know, so here I got some profit on LABU. I want to close it. I go, close that sucker. It's out. Done. All right. Oh, but it's going to break the consolidation. And I'll show you another way that I use VT. This is more for owners out there. You guys are trading this thing. Is when I see something like this happening, I'm going to get me an alert line. This is a great feature in VT. Put that line right there. It's like a trot line in the water. And when that thing goes off, it's going to verbally tell me you broke a resistance level. And I just go right to that candidate. It's going to be sitting right here in my fired alerts and I can trade it. And that's a beautiful setup for a long trade right there. I probably should just go ahead and do it. But anyway, I'm up 250 on Vino. Well, heck, close that sucker. Let me get to Vino here. Vino. All right. Now, instead of closing it, what I can do is what Jeff teaches in his video, which is you pull this fixed loss stop up behind it. Right there, and I've locked in, you know, a little bit less of a loss. I'm gonna let it develop a little more before I close that trade, but there you go, that's good. Okay, so we're cooking. But it's just so fluid. I mean, if I close this, it doesn't matter, because if I hit a chevron, you know, it's gonna come back again and say, give me the one for this. It puts the symbol up here, Vino's right there. It's the one I'm trading, and I can just knock myself out, do all kinds of stuff. Okay, so like I say, I mean, you can see over here, let me go and close this for now, these symbols coming in. Now let's talk about why VT a little bit more, because right now, you know, VT has this notion of a transform, which is indicators that are firing, indicators that are being displayed as color and height. So I know these bad boys are taking off, going up. That's probably Vino there, that's what I got into. Yep, right there. But what I can do is sort the list to show that. And I can actually have a second list down here for my short candidates. So this is the above column. So my really strong movers are these three guys up here. This one is experiencing a pullback because it's red. That's CREX, but it isn't in a bullish mode. It just hasn't had a pullback. That's a pretty decent little candidate right there. Let's put an alert line on that sucker. Draw a trend line. Okay, it just told me LABU resistance. That's that line I just drew. There it is, it's going through resistance. Okay, buy that sucker, let's go. All right, 10%, heck, I wanna do 20% on this trade now, let's do it, we're in. All right, 20% in just like that. And I can add, so they don't have any stops on here, I can add a stop loss at my moving average by pulling the chevron down, as you know. And I'm gonna slow down here, I feel like I'm a racetrack marker or something. Okay, I'm gonna slow down. So I pull the chevron, I get excited, I get on it. And I hit submit, and now I've got my stop right there. So there you go. Oh, I'm up $600 in Vino. Let's look. Yeah, baby, we're cooking. Okay, rather than getting out of this, I'm gonna pull my little thing up here because I think that's gonna keep going. You know, why get out now? We're having fun. Let's stay in. I've got $700 though so far, so yay, it's awesome. Okay, let's see. So VisualTrader, again, your strong mover is right here at the top. So I can just click these guys and look at them and say, ooh, that one looks pretty good. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I can just get in. This one's a trend following trade. Let's see, PTX, oh my goodness. We've up here, we've consolidated. It's going up again. What's a Q doing? Is it rallying? Ah, it kind of is. Okay, I've got Q in my watch list down here. And I can put any symbol in my watch list that I want to put there. Heck, Vino's done so well for me, I can put that down there. Let me grab Vino from the left and drag it across my screen and stick it in the watch list. Now it's right there, I can bring it up whenever I want, just from there. So I know I'm talking fast, but I just want to give you the sense that this thing is a trading machine. It is like giving you the information, telling you where the signals are happening, showing you the strength, the weakness. And you can have a bunch of other industry groups sitting out here with this. So you can have other things that aren't being alerted, but they're still generating signals. You can click on them or hit to see the signals in the list and decide if you want to trade other things. Maybe the groups that have moved the most in the last couple of days. You can easily get those in VisualTrader from OmniScans in VisualTrader. I didn't do that for this demo. It's too much to do today, but they're just, it's so wide open in terms of what you can do with it, how you can trade. I'm going to show you one more thing. I want to turn this over to Jeff here really quickly. You can use a layout to say, you know, let me prospect. Let's say here, Vino, I've got it. I've got, what is this, AVXL, or I go from the right over here, LABU. I'm in that one. And I can lock them in and just keep filling up this layout with different trades I'm in and watch them all on one screen. So again, we have webinars that show all this stuff. I know those of you who have it have seen them, and that's awesome. Those of you who don't, I just got to tell you, this is the best thing since sliced bread for trading. It is just so incredibly powerful. And I hope I did it justice, because I don't know. It's hard. There's the hot buttons, and then we go to the integrated system. You guys didn't need to see me for a few minutes here, so let me douse that. So you got market scans, feeding VisualTrader, the voice alerts in the scans if you want them. VisualTrader will show you the signals as they're firing on the right, and they'll flash right there, and you click them and you see the trade. You know, trade with the hot buttons, get in, get out, whatever you want to do, in multiple times, scale out, all those things, which we're really working to perfect that technique, by the way. It's something new. We have not had the ability to do that before. So, and it's been fun. We've been doing pretty well with it, actually. So that's all simple. It's integrated, and it just shows you the good stuff. Okay, I've got a few recent signals. I want to turn this over to Jeff for his part. And he's got some awesome strategies and stuff to show you. So I don't want to hog the show too much here, but I figure I've got a couple of minutes. So these are just some signals you can see, recent signals leading right before the release. This thing's only been out a couple of weeks. So amazing wave trader signals here. Look at this one down here. That's what you want. There's those runners like that, or this runner like this. And you got a signal there, runner. There, runner down. This is on the 26th and the 28th. Signal here. So not a lot of signals in this chart, but the ones that you do see are pretty dang good. And then I did a test right before we released it. I wanted to trade in the market one morning for about an hour. So 45 minutes, I was up $3,000. And that's even with a turkey trade I did that I didn't get out of right there on MOXC. So that was my big loss, $1,500. But the others more than made up for it. So that was what happened in that trade. Here's a couple I was in, a short there and a short here, and they just moved. So like I say, if you are day trading right now with something, I don't know how it could be better than this, because it's just handing the stuff to you on a silver platter. that you can make all this money with. We've been getting really great testimonials. I'm going to try to show a couple to you in a little while after Jeff finishes. But let's talk about what's with the package and kind of what the deal is. CatchWave is a complete, hold on, there you go. CatchWave is a complete real-time trading method that is very easy to use. Everything you need is there, including the software, the data. Data is a separate subscription, but we do give some data to you to start with this to get going. If you're new to day trading and never thought you might want to do it, you just watched me do it, made money really quickly, you know, so you might just decide, hey, I think I'd like to try that. Okay, we got you set up. So it is complete, including the education that both Jeff and I have done. So what you get is the two platforms with it, strategy that Jeff has created with trade plans and these market scans to do a really good job of feeding you these things, not just at the open, but throughout the day, and then the seminars on how to use it. And so honestly, we have spent easily, I'm gonna say 3 months on this, you know, a couple of us working on it almost full time. I mean, it's like almost 6 man months of work. And plus you got, you know, Barry and QA and Angela and folks trading in here with it. So it's a lot more than that in reality. And so we were, what do we price this at? You know, what do you charge for something that can do this kind of a job for day traders? And those moves are big. I mean, you can make thousands and thousands of dollars if you get on the right side of them at the right time. And so we're thinking, should it be $5,000? Should it be, you know, $3,000? We kind of came up to $3,000 is probably the right price for everything included with this, including additional support that we're doing. I'll get to that in a minute. So anyway, that's all that's included in the package. And you know, like I said, we struggle with it. We finally came down to our introductory offer, which I'm sure if you've been to the site, you've seen it. We are going to release to the public for $29.95, but in this offer, you're getting it for just $19.95. And that's a pre-public release offer. It's for this software, it's really, really good, and everything you get that's included with it. And I wanted to show you this early in the webinar, so you saw the offer that we have that's out there that you're probably already aware of, just to talk about how good I think it is, again, compared to all the things out there you can use. I could mention the products, I won't, but you know what I'm saying. So with that, having showed you this, I want to bring Jeff on now to talk about, you know, his perspective and how he built the strategies he built and why they're so powerful and what he's doing right now. And when he's done, I'm going to get on and tell you about some more goodies that we're cooking up to add to CatchWave. So Jeff, are you out there?
I'm here. Hey, everybody.
All right. Good to see you, man.
Yeah, good to see you. And thanks, everybody, for showing up this afternoon. As you can tell, very excited. Ed's very excited. We're all very excited about CatchWave. And we're actually trying to use it daily. And unfortunately, sometimes the old job, the 9-to-5, takes you away from that. But it's really nice to Angela, can you go ahead and pass me the screen here? Hang on a sec, everybody. Yeah.
Yes.
And
can get it?
Hang on.
I can get you.
There we go. Thank you.
You got it?
All right.
Okay.
Yep. Got it. Thank you, Ed. But anyway, so yeah, it's, as far as a complete package, let me just quickly switch over to my version of VisualTrader here. And basically, it even though you have everything going on with the market scans and you know, you have the alerts as well. I turned my alerts off because I knew we were going to do a webinar. I didn't want the alerts going off on me through the webinar. It's really just sitting here and having it feed you these candidates. And when Larry came to us with his results and his ideas as far as, hey, look what I'm doing, and I'm doing great with these different components. Well, we sewed it all together, as Ed was saying, but we also wanted to automate as much of this as possible. And actually, you can see this morning, I didn't plan on trading, but I had a meeting with Ed. It was about 30 minutes long. I knew we had the Fed announcement coming this afternoon. And normally, I'm looking to catch a runner. But I thought, well, I'll just go ahead and use some targets. And just half an hour in between, you know, talking with Ed, just throwing some trades on when the signals came in. I had one large one here, GLTO. Let me show you that. Boom, just really took off after I got the signal there. I turned off one of the strategies here. That's why you don't see it. You can see that, again, very easy because it's all fed to you. The market scans automatically populate VisualTrader. The strategies with the alerts, I really like the alerts. You don't have to use the alerts if you don't want, but they really help me because I can do something, you know, over on this desktop and then, hey, do I have an alert? Let me take a look at it. I'll pass. Or, hey, look, that looks like a good opportunity. I'll just go ahead and put a trade on. So anyway, I want to talk a little bit though more about the automation process behind this, because that was one of Larry's ideas, and we automated a lot of this process to make it as easy as possible to engage. So let me go back to my presentation. And Ed already showed you the complete package slide here. I want to talk about the scans themselves. And when you purchase the program, those of you already own it, you have access to it in your dashboard. But basically, let me kill the video here. There we go. But basically, you know, at different times of the day, you may want to turn on different scans. And this was really when Larry came to us, he was looking at the pre-market and at the open. And then he's actually on the West Coast. And so he has some time before he went to work to trade, and he would trade, and he'd do very, very well with this just by using a scan he found with another company. And we said, well, we can do that. So we made the catch a wave scans, and Ed already talked about the difference between catch a wave and liquid. Sometimes catch a wave will find these illiquid stocks. And so a lot of times you may just want to focus on liquid. But then we also, and this is Larry's idea as well, said, what if you just found the opportunities out there that didn't meet the scan initially, but we're generating signals that would be in the strategy? He said, great, let's go ahead and do that. And he said, I have these active here. And another one that I have, I've actually been using this one for years when I trade real time, just showing stocks that are really moving throughout the session. All right, so let's talk about these individually. The catch a wave scan is basically looking for abnormal moves overnight, post-market, pre-market, whatever. And you know, a lot of times there'll be news that'll come out on something that will really drive a stock up or down. And so it comes in at the open, you have this big reaction to it. And part of this is, you know, some of these meme stocks, huge gap at the open. Well, you see a lot of selling pressure come in. That's really, as Ed said, the trade Larry was focusing on is what he calls the pump and dumps. And you know, they pump up the price and then they dump it, make a profit. And then he would be shorting that in order to go ahead and make a profit himself. All right. And these are also the stocks that a lot of people are focusing on. You look at a lot of real-time traders and they are focused on, you can call them meme stocks, as some of them are. Otherwise, they are just stocks that have this abnormal movement overnight. They come in at the open and they continue to move, and normally the other direction. But we are basically, we're taking a look at it, and there's opportunities in both directions. You know, Larry was focusing on shorts. We're looking at it from a long perspective. In fact, I kind of gravitate to longs, and you still see great opportunities for long traders as well. And Ed already talked about the liquid scans there as well. So at the open or pre-market, you could use this scan. In fact, this, I would recommend only using this one. In fact, in the seminar that we provide, I talk about the recommended basically schedule for turning scans on and off. I'll show you how to do that here in just a moment. All right, then the second one are the V-wave scans. And these are the ones that are basically close to a mimic of the strategies, which we'll talk about here in just a bit. But you can see that the signal that was generated here, basically the scan found this. It said, hey, it's about to cross. The moving average is about to cross VWAP. We had the wave change at this point. So it will go ahead and just feed this to you in your scan, which, you know, I say in the scan, it actually will pop up as an alert in your Visual Trader. And so there's AMC, talk about a meme stock, but it comes in there. You see the signal that's generated. There it's pulled back. It tested VWAP, confirmation that there is a reaction to VWAP on this move. And there is the subsequent downward move. Nice trade there for AMC. So very cool. And we're not going to inundate you with a bunch of potential signals. There are filters in the scan saying, look, it needs to be moving. It needs to be changing waves. And it also needs to be reacting to this VWAP. However, that has been defined in this example, that is with the moving average crossing the VWAP, with all these other filters in place in order to take I'm sorry, just looking at the comments there, somebody's making money on Vino over there as well. Awesome. No, it's basically feeding this to you. So we're trying to find the best opportunities in the market. All right. So that's the other, and we have scans for long and short for what is called the V-wave scan. And then the other scan is one that later on in the day, once you have the, you know, the catch a wave scans have really cooled down quite a bit. Also, since VWAP is a cumulative indicator, at times throughout the day, price will just completely move away from it. You won't get another opportunity because price is so far away from VWAP. So what we are doing is also scanning the market later on in order to find stocks that are really moving. What else is moving out there? Hey, you know, news happens during the day all the time. There's some buying orders coming in, you know, institutions will put on a buy program to really drive a stock. So the intraday movers, you can see a list of them here, will find those, feed those right into your visual trader. And then you don't have to react at any point. Let the strategies do their work. All right. And so you can see here's an example, right? Bingo. At the open, it didn't gap at all. So you wouldn't have seen this trade, although it was a good trade. But later on in the day, this scan found it, said, oh, hey, we have some abnormal movement that's happened here. There it crossed, and we can go ahead and use the strategies in order to engage these fast-moving stocks later on in the session. Okay, so that goes over the scans that we provide. Let me also say that, of course, you can customize these scans any way you want or add a scan. Ed talked about adding some industry groups or so on. There's a scan called Big Movers. It's an intraday scan. I like that. And if things are a little slow, I'll go ahead and turn that on in order to get some more candidates. This day, candidates were not a problem. But there's times, you know, there's catch a wave. These aren't moving as much. Maybe there's not as much intraday movers, so big moves will find them. You can try anything as far as adding stocks in and let the strategies do the work for you, which segues us to discussing the strategies that are included with Catch a Wave. And again, these are very close to the definition of the trading approach that Larry Smith uses to this day. He's actually trading it this morning. And one of them is the VP cross strategy. We've already alluded to this a little bit. Here is a signal on ASXC. And you can see what we're looking for is this wave change. You have, when we talk about waves, of course, we're talking about trend. So it has changed at this point, pushing upward. And then here is the cross. This is exactly what Larry was using. Now, again, he liked the short, but you can see good long opportunities here as well. Look at the price on this, at $2.2. And look at the run. Outstanding gain on this opportunity. Now, you may also choose to use targets like I did. And in fact, our strategies, we have two different versions of each. I'll talk about the trade plans associated with them. But two different versions because one has targets in the trade plan. The other one is trying to basically trail a very strong trending move like this. All right. So that is one of the strategies that is provided. The second one is called the pivot change strategy. And this is one, this is a good example here on VIXY. You can see there's VWAP. And here today, the value of the security just completely fell off. It's not going to visit VWAP again. You're not going to get this moving average cross again, but you may get another opportunity. So this is one that seems to work better throughout the day as there's new opportunities coming in. Here's an example. You already had the cross, but we didn't have trend confirmation yet. Once we get trend confirmation and we still have that cross though, this will fire. Now that said, there's other filters in the strategies in order to make sure that we have sufficient movement, we have sufficient volume, so on and so forth, right? But basically what you're finding here is, okay, it already crossed, but this is still a good opportunity, exactly what we see here. I did talk about the two different trade plans. So we have those two strategies and we have two versions of each. One is using a targets trade plan. It has a target to the upside, target to the downside. And it's basically just two ATRs. It gives you a way to say, oh, hey, I'll go ahead and take that trade and I'll apply that trade plan. I'll go back into VT here and show you how cool it is. Market's still moving. Good. It's still open. But you can basically apply it and then move it based off what's going on with that chart. You know, particularly at the open, you know, if it's gapped away, it's really difficult to get some automated targets set. But it's pretty easy to see, okay, there's a relative high, there's a relative low. Let me just kind of move them out there and manage the trade myself. So it allows you to easily do that. All right, so that's one of the trade plans. The second one is the one that I prefer. This is called the Catch a Wave Trending Trade Plan. And this is really trying to find a runner. And here's an example here for Express. There's our change of a wave while we have VWAP above, moving average above VWAP. There's the signal. What it'll do is say, okay, once I get a nominal move, it may be hard to see here, but there's a break-even exit. And this is just beautiful to use throughout the day, particularly if you're doing something else, which a lot of us are doing. So it'll move up here and it activates this break-even stop. At that point, I pretty much just ignore it. Let it run. And you can see this trade actually stayed in trade until the next wave change. So it got a lot of that move. All right, but since I know I already have that break-even stop in there, I don't have to worry about coming all the way down to my fixed loss stop. I have that to protect me. It'll lock in a little profit, but it's basically saying I'm not going to take a big hit on this. I can go ahead and let it run. Another example there in the day, and sometimes it doesn't run. Here's an example right here, right? 12:30, it's around lunchtime there, so market's not moving as much. Pushed up, there's the break-even exit that came in, and went ahead and stopped out because it didn't run. It did later though, good opportunity there. Another example, coming back and hitting that break-even, but hey, you're still making a little bit on, and some of these low-priced stocks, it doesn't take much of a move to make a lot. You're still making a nice little gain there as well. All right, now for those of you that already own Catch a Wave, I have some exciting news because Ed and I have been trading a new strategy that we have developed, and it is called the Catch a Wave VWAP Bounce Strategy. What we noticed when we engaged this, and again, like you said, we've been doing this for months as far as looking at how the market is reacting to the VWAP indicator as well as other things. What we noticed is that a lot of the times you would see this bounce off of VWAP, and it would provide a great opportunity. This is actually from today. And so what we have now, there's filters saying, all right, we need it to be moving back towards VWAP in a direction that we can expect the bounce. And of course we have, you know, liquidity filters as well. But exactly, you know, what you see now, this is a huge move, not the ideal entry, but you can see the sell-off continued here on APRE. This is just an example, but we're seeing this time and time again when you get this test of VWAP. Again, retail traders alike out there following VWAP, there's this self-fulfilling prophecy with this indicator because so many people are looking at it. This is a great example. So this is the new strategy that we are currently trading as well as testing. I think we're basically done, and this will be coming in a updated version of Catch a Wave here in just a bit. Very excited about this. This is at least later in the day. I really, really like these signals. Early on, Larry's signals are great. But again, you may not get them later on in the day. This allows you to trade anytime in the session and find some great trading opportunities. Now, without trying to steal any of Ed's thunder, I do want to talk some other stuff that we have coming with Catch a Wave. When we put this initial package together, it was basically, okay, here is a great starting point. We have good strategies, we have the trade plans, we have the scanner working with Visual Trader, so on and so forth, got the hot buttons. But there's other things that can make this even better. And that is, we're continuing to work on this. Larry brought up an entry indicator, just a line in the chart showing where the entry is. And so we will be adding that here shortly. Also with the hot buttons, it's no longer just get in here, get out there. It's I got in here and then I doubled my size and I took a quarter off here, so on and so forth. So those orders should be reflected in the chart, and some other programs will do that. We will be adding that to the Catch a Wave. Actually, it's probably be part of Visual Trader, but you know, it's the whole package. And so we'll be adding that as well. And I'm working on another strategy that is looking at the break of VWAP. Now, this one's a little more difficult because it can't just be moving through VWAP. It has to have a decisive move. There have to be other things in the chart that are saying, oh, hey, we have buying coming in or selling, either direction, but we have this happening. Because there's a reaction to VWAP, and instead of letting it get away from us, we get an entry on that is, of course, qualified by other factors that will lead us to other great opportunities for Catch a Wave. Also, I think Ed's going to talk about this here in just a moment. We're also looking at a Catch a Wave trading room that will be announced soon. In fact, I think Ed will announce it here in just a bit so that you're not out there on your own. Other people that are using the exact same tools to engage the market, you can communicate with them, and that includes us. We'll be in there talking about the trades that we're seeing, what's going on in the market, so on and so forth. Very excited about that because you know that sitting in the isolation with any type of trading is difficult, and hearing what other people are thinking and sharing their profits and sometimes their losses, it's good to hear that other people are in the boat with you, ready to help you out. So very excited about that. And I think Ed's going to talk more about that here as I turn it back over to Ed, see what else he has for us.
Okay. Well, that was awesome, Jeff. Really good stuff. And I got to vouch for Jeff. He's been working on, we've all been working on it, but especially Jeff, because we're not done. This is really good stuff. You saw how easy it was for me to engage the market. In fact, I have something to show you here on that trade. So we're making money with this thing, having fun with it, and it's great. But we you know, using it, you just discover stuff. And so we're continuing to improve it, and we're going to provide these updates to our users continuously as we do that. We're not going to, you know, just going to keep putting it out there, new strategies, new scans, as we use it every day. Pretty much everybody in here is doing that. I just want to show you this trade I did on Vino. It had the classic breakout. This is the signal. This is the signal. Now I gotta get on camera to say this. Okay, so say it again. Okay, this is the signal. Perfect poster child. I'm so glad it happened during the webinar, but you know, consolidated, going through VWAP, you got the green, and it did 50% move in what? During the webinar, 30 minutes, I don't know. So of course I got out right here somewhere, up there, somewhere in here, but before I pass to Jeff, but anyway, it's just really, really fun to play this thing and make money with it. I've got a couple more things to show you. Just, I'd mentioned some testimonials that came in. These just last couple days, you know, someone's saying they think our resources for CatchWave are great. You know, one price and all that, he appreciates it. Never used VisualTrader before. Haven't even spent a lot of time with it, but I'm starting to feel pretty comfortable with the paper trading. So that's great. Thanks, Barry. And then Tom sent this one in. CatchWave scan is a real winner. All sessions pre-market. I'll check aftermarket later today. And his team has delivered an awesome sweeper. It does what it's designed for and nails it down. The rest falls on the trader, of course, to make a final buy-sell decision. Thanks again. Happy trails from here on. So we appreciate those. And you owners out there, we want to hear from you. So as you use this thing and engage the market, let us know how you're doing. We've been hearing this stuff and really, really enjoy it. So I have a special announcement. And Jeff, you did steal some of my thunder over there, old buddy. You did do that, but it's okay. It's okay. I know you're excited about it as well. I'm kidding you. We want to support our users as much as we can. And we've been doing these webinars for that purpose. But we're looking at how to really do that, every day in the markets. And so Jason and Ryan are our staff, sort of really got into these Discord channels, the Discord product, which is very large. It was used mostly by gamers in the early days, you know, to pass around their gaming tips and stuff. But now there's a lot of traders that use it. And actually, Larry's in a Discord room. He's been in for a long time. And so we have created a channel for our company, and we'll be hosting a Catch a Wave, or a server, I guess. We'll be hosting a Catch a Wave channel within the Discord room, and basically posting everything in there, you know, getting people to share their trades, to share whatever indicator adjustments they've made, they found to be useful, or whatever. It'll be like an ongoing interactive community is really what it is. And like I say, we will go in there and provide tips and trades and, you know, whatever. We're not going to just sit there and trade in front of people, because, you know, and the reason for that is we're providing the perfect tool to engage the market. And so we know that from all the feedback we've gotten, that you get that thing in front of you and you're probably seeing trades, you know, that maybe I didn't see because of the path you took or how you adjusted the scan or whatever. So it's really an individual exercise, but we can continue to help people with, you know, different tactics as we get better at it, and as other users will do the same thing. So all I can tell you is we're gonna be posting stuff in there that's useful. And then the big thing is for all of y'all, we've got quite a number of Catch a Wave owners right now, for you guys to get in there and share your insights with everybody else. And, you know, that's what it's all about. And we have the best community with Nirvana and the Nirvana Club, of course. Amazing people who share willingly, much more so than the trading rooms I've looked at, you know, just looking out there, or trading, whatever places where people congregate for trading. So it's going to be a great resource. So the plan is to launch that Monday. And so ahead of Monday, we'll send out information to all of our owners and tell you exactly how to get in there. And we'll just have a good party on Monday launching the thing. And if you're not in, you know, not a Catch a Wave owner yet, I encourage you to get this thing. It is covered by our guarantee. And just get started. I mean, you saw the move I just showed you. Jeff showed you his move. This stuff is happening every day, pretty much. Now, today was slow early, but then it kind of picked up. So you never know when that's going to happen. But some days are phenomenal. So, hey, all I can say is get involved. We're here with you. We want you to succeed. We'll keep giving you updated assets as we discover better ways to use the thing. And, you know, but I'm telling you, with that scanner and VisualTrader and what's been done with that magic, it's just like, oh my goodness. I mean, it's so engaging. It's almost addicting, I have to say. you sit in front of it, you know, I'm gonna bring up BT again. You sit in front of the thing and you're just waiting, you know, for scans to come in and clicking them over here on the right, or in the list, you know, go through all these things. Look at this. I mean, VisualTrader is just giving you this stuff on a silver platter. Look at that. So it's just fun. you know, it's not stressful. I've day traded before where I had to go find stuff or just use, you know, a focus list with some signals in it. And it was not like this. This is just a load of fun. You've got all these tools in VT that you can use to, you know, improve your experience. So would encourage you to do that if you have any interest in it at all, because it is awesome. Okay. So here's back to that offer again. We are planning to sell the whole package with the training that we provide and access to the Catch a Wave owner room. That's not going to be open to the public. It's only going to be for owners. Get in there and share stuff. We don't want people just in there poking around. It's got to be people who have a skin in the game and have jumped in with us on this. But so, you know, but we will go out with that. We're gearing up for our public release. It's only been out about 3 weeks, and we've already made tremendous progress in kind of getting things lined up, but we're not quite ready. So we've still got the special offer going. And there's the website, nirvanasystems.com/catch-a-wave. And that's it. Okay. So once again, Catch a Wave, and it says with me, but of course Jeff was on with me, and Jeff, really appreciate all that you shared from what you're doing. The guy, you know, Jeff's been making these trading system strategies for over 20 years here, and pretty much all of our staff has been here about 20 years, so everybody's very committed to our customers, our company, our mission, and I just appreciate all of you who have come on and purchased Catch a Wave and are working with it and sending us your success stories. Really, really, really great. Just an awesome thing. So I'm going to check that we got another 10 minutes or so, see if there's any questions. I tried to answer some while Jeff was talking. Let's see. Okay. James says, awesome. We'd love to have you guys on Discord. Well, you got your wish, James, because we're going to be there Monday. PMs. Perry says, Discord rocks. All right. And Gary says, now you're not familiar with it. Actually, I wasn't familiar with it either, honestly, until I met Larry. I had no idea it was even out there. He goes, is Discord a separate app or will it be in VT? It's a website. So it's like a forum, except it's live. The stuff is happening live in there. And I haven't actually used it yet. I've got to be briefed by the team that's putting it together, but it's very easy to pass information back and forth between people. It's designed for gamers. They have a small attention span, you know. So it's just very vigorous, a lot of information in there, and you divide up into channels, topics, you know, that are covered. So then some channels can be locked out, like our owners only channel will be for owners only. And then there's the more public channels where people can, you know, look at the concepts or whatever is appropriate for the Discord server. So anyway, I'm just watching comments coming in here. You guys love this thing. Okay. all right. Very good. Yeah. So a lot of things about the Discord group. So that'll be launched Monday. And like I say, we'll have more webinars for owners, you know, coming up here with what we're discovering and how to use it more effectively. Jeff is doing his strategy work. I also am working on a strategy concept for scaling in continuously, you know, automatically. So what I'm doing, I'll just tell you what it is. It's like you see the thing like I saw, right, on Vino, and you go, that's a really good opportunity. And you click that signal and boom, there it goes. And so if it runs, you know, if it pulls back a little bit and starts running again, sorry, this way, pulls back a little bit, starts running again, that it can say, okay, add more to my position. Of course, that's all trade plan defined. It'll be changeable by anybody, but that's what I'm experimenting with because I see tremendous potential for scale in trades during the market to amplify those profits. So that's my little science project that I'm working on. But as we get these things done and like we're trading with them, that's pretty good stuff. We'll just push it out there, you know, update the installation and let everybody know where to get the new assets. So very vigorous activity going on right now. You can tell this is the thing that we are working on. This is it. We're not, you know, I mean, this is it. This is what everyone here is doing every day. It's our mission. And so we want to, you know, keep it out there and just, you know, keep going. It's honestly fun. We've had day trading products for a long time. And, you know, several really great strategies, in fact, that Jeff made a while back. RTSS was one of them. But we've never had this combination of assets, of technology that just, like Jeff said, he said it perfectly, just serves them to you one after another. Check this one out. And you go, oh, my goodness. Yeah. And you're just sitting there and they're coming to you. I mean, it's amazing. So with that asset, we can now keep going on real-time stuff and really make a big difference for our users. So that's what we're about. Jeff, did you have anything else to add to before we close out today?
No, there's a question here. Steve is asking, because when I showed my open positions, it was just for today. And he says, can the open and close window be set just for today? And that's one of those features. There's a lot of features I probably forgot to mention that are coming. That is one. Well, you'll have it to where your position window will just reflect today's trading. So you can share that with other people. A lot of other programs do that. And so we're going to do that as well. So good question, Steve, and that is coming.
Yes, it's high on the list, on the enhancement list.
Yes.
There's several like that, but yes. Yep. We're bugging the developers every day. Can we just have this? This is one more little thing here. You know, aren't we done yet? Nope. Let's see. Philip says, I remember the early bash, and this is what you were dreaming about. You're exactly right. When Constantine made that scanner work the way it does and hooked it into VT with the voice telling you what's happening, yeah, it's just fun and profitable. Hey. Okay, Marty says, thanks, Ed and Jeff. Excellent product. Thank you, sir. Appreciate that. And let's look at the other. Let's see. Okay, I think this has all been answered. Yeah. I think we're good on questions. All right, folks. Well, thanks again for coming. This was recorded, and so it'll be out there if you missed any part of it. And let's just keep catching waves. I don't know. That's all I can say. Jeff, thank you for coming on again.
You bet.
Sharing all the good work that you've been doing. You're just amazing.
Well, thank you.
As you know, you've talked to our staff, all those guys out there supporting this, Scott, Barry, Nathan, Angela, Ryan, Steve, our COO, all using this product every day and all have been supporting our customers every way they can. So if you guys are on, thank you too. You guys are doing a great job out there. All right. And Jason, rallying us on marketing. So, okay. Thanks, folks. We'll look forward to seeing you again real soon, and we'll keep you updated as we keep going with Catch a Wave. Thanks. Take care.